started the team in 1974. Donis Thompson was hired as the athletic director and hired Alan Kang. Alan got the best 6-7 girls that he could in the state of Hawaii at the time, and that was our beginning.
We did play in Clem Gym, and we practiced in Clem Gym, so it was a combination of things. We had to wait outside until the basketball team was done practicing before we could even go in the gym.
We only had about 8 players at that time. Even my junior and senior year, we were a small team, but we were second in the nation to UCLA in the national championship, so we laid the foundation.
It was just overwhelming. It seems like it was even more so at the beginning because it was so fresh and brand new.
I guess it was a beginning of evolution for volleyball, because back then we didn't have like a whole lot of club teams what they have now. So I would say we were grassroots, and we kind of started the program.
My scholarship was $25, free education and a $25 check. I checked with one of the boys, the football players who was in line at the time, and again, this was 1974, 75. Excuse me, how much do you get on your check? He got $125. I got $25.
They've really built the program, the people in the 70s, you know, and I don't know if our girls today appreciate exactly what went through, how the program evolved to what it is today. All they see is like, wow, this is pretty cool. And so, you know, that part is just amazing how it's really grown.
Dave was great. He was good. And he taught me a lot. He was hard back then. But the girls respected him.
I mean, Dave taught when he was at UH, you know, so he wasn't just a coach. He taught, you know, he taught classes. So, you know, I enjoy seeing what I see now, and it can only get better, I think.
We got the best fans, they're most knowledgeable, they're courteous, they're so supportive, and that's one of our biggest recruiting tools.
Blaisdell was sold out back then, and it was just the excitement and the enthusiasm and the fans were just unbelievable.
You realize that Dave really brought out the best in you. You know, I have a lot of stories about Dave, but I remember we were working out and he wanted to arm wrestle me. Of course, he picks me to arm wrestle. So I said, okay, come on. We both got on the table and arm wrestled, and I won. But that motivates us, you know, that competitiveness in Dave. He wanted to race me a couple times, but that just brought out the best in us.
People were just amazing. I'd walk into a restaurant after we had won the national title, and people stood up and they wanted to shake my hand. And, you know, it was new for me as well. I was just excited. I was on cloud 9 from winning. And it's just amazing to think, you know, the passion that people had, and they really took us into their homes, whether it was just through their television or actually being there. So I was just so blessed to play at a place where I think people value volleyball.
Rainbow Wahine Volleyball is very similar to a sorority. You got your family, you guys have all been there, done that, you're together, you got each other's backs. So the Rainbow Wahine it's like a culture. You're a part of something that is really pretty phenomenal.
Having been a Wahine means that I was a part of a very special legacy that I had the chance to honor in my 5 years there, and now honor those who were our predecessors, kind of, the women like Beth McLaughlin and Robin Amo and all those other terrific athletes and outstanding women who came before us, who built the program off of their success. And now, when I came in, I get to enjoy on the success that they had built for us, and then kind of creating our own legacy as a team for the 5 years that I was there.
Well, I came here on a recruiting trip, and I just fell in love with the place. I actually remember watching Hawaii play Michigan when they were in the Final Four on TV when I was in high school. And I remember seeing the crowd and just, I don't know, Hawaii itself, you know, the name Hawaii. And I remember just saying, like, how'd be cool to play in front of that crowd, or, you know, and play for Dave Shoji.
This tradition in this program's been, you know, since the early 70s, and actually late 70s, and, you know, with the championships won in 82, 83, and then I came in 91, they'd won a championship in 87, so they definitely had this feeling of being treated very special here on the islands. It was an amazing place, and definitely the people for me built that kind of legend and history into the program, so.
I remember growing up, we used to pretend that we were like UH players, me and my friends, and we used to always play volleyball every like break we could, and it's great watching like people. It's like role models mostly for us, because we really wanted to be them, you know, someone to look up to, someone to aspire to be.
I was also a ball girl and a floor wiper, so watching Ashley Watanabe and just her on the court and her spunk and her drive to play made me really want to be a Wahine.
Every game, there's the aunties in the corner that give us lays. They take time to make the lays. People that give us food after the game, and just everyone that comes out and supports us, takes time off to help us out.
She used to give to some of the players, and I thought it would be nice to give all the players. So I started to, you know, buy some lays to give to the team. And then later on, it got too expensive, so I started to make the lays myself.
What does it mean? You know, all the support, a little pressure maybe. What does it mean to be a UH Wahine?
It's a privilege. It's an honor to be a Wahine. We're just set on such a pedestal in Hawaii, and we take on a bigger role for the community. And Dave has brought a legacy, and the women in the past have created such a great legacy. So I think it's an honor to be a Wahine. It's a privilege. We're very lucky, very fortunate, and it's awesome.
To be a Wahine is such an honor, to put on the jersey and represent not only ourselves and our family, but the entire state.
To be a Wahine is just, you know, you're a role model to younger kids, you know, hold you accountable, you know, to be a person of great character. And it's just exciting, you know, just to have the whole state supporting you.
It's definitely a stepping stone in life to become, you know, if you are a Rainbow Wahine volleyball girl, and you've made it throughout the whole college career, and you can say that you've done a good job of being a role model for your little ones, especially for me. I have two younger sisters, and I want to be the best that I can and make sure that I do well in school and then have a great career and hopefully then some after. I know that I've done my job, at least for my grandparents and parents.
You know, their experiences here, they'll never forget that. And I'm hoping, you know, the public never forgets the players that come here either. And I think that's the case. It's a mutual thing where the girls love being a Wahine and the public loves the Wahines.
My advice is to follow your heart. And if you really feel like this is something that it just keeps popping up and popping up and popping up and it won't go away, then stay with it. If somebody tells you no, that's okay. Walk down the street and you make it happen. If it's really in your heart, follow it. That is my number one advice. Follow your heart.